indigenous people of this land. The Chinese came in, mixed in with them, and produced what you're calling Native Americans today, or Indians. And the Caucasian gave them all our rights.
Right.
Now they're walking around saying Cherokee, Choctaw, Shinnecock, Cheyenne, and we're walking around saying African, African, African.
The following movie is rated R.
'95, 1896, when a lot of the whites found out the benefits that these blacks are going to be entitled to. A lot of whites went to the Dawes Commission and say, look, why don't you put my name on there? They said, but you're not an Indian. They said, well, I'll give you $5. So then the rule got around, the posse got around that for $5 that a white could put his name on the Dawes rolls and be called himself an Indian and be entitled to all these benefits, and all their children could be entitled to all these benefits forever. And so that became known as what's called a $5 Indian. And so if you go around now and check most of the Indians, the so-called Indians in America, about 90% of them are not even Indians. Those are just whites now who are passing as Indians. And but they're getting all the benefits. And they're not paying any taxes, getting free college education. They put up a little reservation on the land that they don't live on. They have another home off and get all kind of benefits.
Hello everyone, this is Chief Moonwolf.
Okay, and anything in the Ojibwe culture is, from my own perspective on the things I was taught when I was little.
Shio, my name is Michelle Hicks, Principal Chief of the Eastern Band of the Cherokee Nation.
Look, what the fuck is this?
When I speak it, I kind of think back to my ancestors and think, hey, I'm speaking the same language they did many years ago, and I feel really connected about it. And then I want to learn more.
It's our spirituality, and plus the way we do things, the way we relate to other people. For me, it's a matter of seeing family, because this is one large extended family. We're all related in some way or means.
I've been doing powwows for over 30 years. I'm 69 years old, and the heritage means a lot to me. My regalia is made up of traditional Shawnee.
I'm of the Wolf Clan, and we were the largest and most prominent clan. We were the warrior clan, and we were the only clan who was allowed to kill a wolf. Which is why we're called the Wolf Clan. It's just the little things that I think. I'll probably always have a dream catcher in my room. If I ever have kids, they'll have dream catchers in their room, and I'm gonna try to teach them what I've learned, because I think that's important, to just keep what you think is important alive, because this is a very important part of who I am. Like whenever, on the little bubbles and stuff, whenever you're asked to identify what you are, I choose Native American every single time. It's what I've always done. And I'm not gonna just let my culture be squashed because someone doesn't want me to talk about it.
What the fuck is this?
You are wahoo. Yeah. What is it good for? Absolutely not.
You know, nobody know war.
Everybody knows war. Who? Yeah. What it is it good for? Absolutely nothing. Good God, you all.
It ain't you all, it's y'all.
Y'all.
Y'all!
Y'all!
You sound like a karate movie. Y'all!
Yo!
Say it from right here with some soul. Y'all!
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 Oh,
music, swinging my hips.
I don't know.
Is this you discussing Indian blood? We're going to judge people by whether they have Indian blood, whether they're qualified to run a gaming casino or not?
That probably is me, absolutely. Because I tell you what, if you look at some of the reservations that you've approved, you, sir, in your great wisdom have approved, I will tell you right now,
they don't look like Indians to me.
And they don't look like the Indians. Now, maybe we say politically correct or not politically correct. They don't look like Indians to me, and they don't look like Indians to Indians.
We welcome to Face to Face Tribal Chairman for the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe, Dave Archambeau. And Dave, before we get too far into things, you were first elected as chairman in 2013. What were some of the issues that were facing Standing Rock at the time?
At that time, you know, it's interesting you ask that, because I got to sit down with the former chairman. And the former chairman, his name was Charlie Murphy. And Charlie Murphy became the chairman when he was 32.
We've been trumped. it's not good news for us.
He's going to try to stop it. I wouldn't doubt if he sends the army in pretty soon, you know. He's going to have to kill a lot of us, you know, but it's not going to be that way. This is a prayerful, peaceful thing.
Are you done?
Yeah, we're not going to be trumped. I refuse to be trumped.
Are you done? Are you done? Are you done? Okay. I'm about to shit on this bitch right now.
This is with respect to the construction of the Dakota Access Pipeline. Dakota Access Pipeline. Again, subject to terms and conditions to be negotiated by us. Okay. This is construction of pipelines in this country. We are, and I am, very insistent that if we're going to build pipelines in the United States, the pipe should be made in the United States. Finisher.
Wins. Fatality.
No. No. She wasn't ready. She wasn't ready.
Thousands of Indians are being kicked out of tribes. Critics say it's more about greed than anything else. The tribes say it's about preserving their lineage.
I'm a senior Indian.
For decades, the Madariaga family called this home, the Pechanga Reservation in Temecula. 89-year-old Lawrence and his wife Sophie built their house after he came back from serving in World War II. They raised 4 children, 8 grandchildren, and 12 great-grandchildren.
I grew up here my whole life. This is my home. This is who I am. This is the only thing I know. Everything I ever wanted to do in my life was for my people here.
This is the ancestral home of the Lucinio Indian tribe, and the Madariagas say they can trace their family roots here back more than 100 years.
I don't believe you.
Okay, what is this we're coming up on?
The clinic.
The health clinic.
That's my design.
Lawrence and Sophie say early life on the reservation was hard. Today, though, because of Indian gaming, specifically the Pechanga Resort and Casino in Temecula, those days of poverty are gone. The tribe as a whole shares in the profit, meaning each and every adult member of the tribe receives a monthly check worth thousands of dollars.
We used to get $20,000 a month.
A monthly allowance? Of $20,000.
About that.
The Madariaga family says last August that monthly allowance abruptly stopped. The family was cut off. The term they use is disenrolled. It means Lawrence Madariaga, his wife, and all their children and their children's children were kicked out of the tribe.
They shun you totally. That's what disenrollment means. You're outcasts.
They say the children in the family were even kicked out of the reservation school. The Madariaga family alone had 90 adult members, each receiving that monthly allowance of $20,000.
$24, $25 million a year. Does that mean the money that's left, the other families get a bigger piece of the pie?
Yes. But our issue here again is our heritage. Our heritage. We always knew who we were. My father always taught us who we were.
Well, we don't believe you. You need more people.
So this is all yours in here?
All the family, yes.
The Madariagas are the second family recently disenrolled at Pechanga, bringing the total number at this one reservation to over 220 adults.
I told y'all niggas, I told y'all niggas, y'all thought I was playing, but I told y'all.
It comes as a great shock around the age of 5 or 6 or 7 to discover that the flag to which you have pledged allegiance, along with everybody else, has not pledged allegiance to you. It comes as a great shock to discover that Gary Cooper killing off the Indians when you were rooting for Gary Cooper, that the Indians were you, that the Indians were you.
Wampanoag Way. Meet Tashima and Storm. They're sisters. They're members of the Wampanoag tribe.
Hey, girls.
The girls live typical lives in Massachusetts. They go to school. They ride bikes. They hang out and have fun. But sometimes they get to do something very special. They show others what life was like for their people 400 years ago. That's what some members of the tribe do at the Wampanoag home site. Let's go for a visit. We'll step back in time as the girls show us what life was like for the Wampanoag people in the 1620s.
You know why you can? Don't get a sucker no statue. Give him guts. I told you I wasn't going away. You got your shot. Now give me mine.
Why'd you get the hell out of here?
Shut up, old man. I ain't going nowhere. And why don't you tell all these nice folks why you've been ducking me? Politics, man. This country wants to keep me down. Keep everybody weak. They don't want a man like me to have the title because I'm not a puppet like that fool up there.
You know, you've got a big mouth, you know?
Who wants to come out and close it, bad boy? Come on. Come on.
Like Kimosabe, of course it's me, a better known as the Master G. A fucking new squad, sense the danger.
A powwow, just rock it out, a finger popping to the break of dawn. Keep it rocking like the stuff that we call me.
What's that?
Hot butter popcorn.
Mama told me, ayy, not to sell work.
Mama,
17, 5, same color t-shirt.
Had to call the addy, then the top, I had to chop it. Niggas pocket watching, so I gotta keep the rocket. Neck, water, faucet, water, market, birds, market.
Do it for the culture,
culture.
They gon' buy like vultures. Do it for the culture,
culture.
They gon' buy like vultures.
And a lot of blacks don't know that they are Indians. And
why don't they know?
Well, they've been told that they're African-American and that they came from Africa, but that they've really been here in the United States as Indians.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And they're really just been given false information from the historical point of view.